Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the UMass Minutemen Dynasty here in NCAA 13. The Minutemen are 11-0 and number one in the country, facing a tough foe in ACC play, number 13 Miami. Guess who we most likely get back today? He's listed as probable, Robert Vincent. Oh, he showed so much promise at the start of this year, went down with a bad injury. And tell me, since when is Joseph Jones an 85 plus one? Are you kidding me? With very little time on the field? He plays in spot duty. How did he get to be that high? I don't think he was rated that at the start of the season, was he? Wow, that took me by surprise. I'm going to move him up to number two on the depth chart. Poor Dustin Jones is going to have to play a very much a backup role here. I don't know if he'll see the field much or not, but we've got to play this game against the U, and we've got to do this in Miami if we want to run the table on our regular season undefeated. Ronnie Parker is ready for this game. 8 touchdowns on the year, and Joel Meadows, one of his favorite targets, he and Ronnie Houston. So there we go. We are just about set. Miami ready to come out here in front of their home crowd and take down number one in the nation. They would love nothing better than to do that today, get it done. So as the team gets ready to come out here, and they've got a big crowd behind them, so let's get this going. Here come the Hurricanes, and we are just about ready to start. UMass wins the coin toss and decides to kick off here. They want to defer to the second half, see what their defense can do here. So Sullivan to pass over the middle to Riley. That's a first down right away for the Hurricanes. As Sullivan drops back, he wants to run this time, fooling the UMass defense there and getting a first down. They'll have to think about putting a spy on him as this progresses, but he can also throw the football. We've seen some quarterbacks that can run but couldn't really throw. It looks like we've got a combo platter here in Sullivan. Again, going to take off and get a first down. Nice job of mixing things up here and keeping UMass on their toes. Here they bring a blitz, but they miss. It's going to be first and goal on this nice run as they go right by the blitzing safety and get a first and goal. So here come Miami here. But there's a big play. That's Ben Birch flying right through there and getting his second sack of the year. 63 tackles. Nice job. Second and goal. Running the screen, except that didn't work. He fell down making the catch. Third and goal after a 5-yard false start penalty. And, oh, that could have been picked off, but it's definitely not going to be complete. Miami will have to settle for a field goal attempt, and it will be good. 3-0 Hurricanes. As we get the ball first here, Robert Vincent's first carry in a long time. He gets 5 yards, second and 5. Forgot how explosive this guy is. Look at him hit the hole right up the middle. Oh, he has not lost any of that speed or acceleration from his injury. He looks to be pretty good right out of the chute here, so we'll utilize him. Second and 12, we're going to go play action. Hit Reed, the tight end here. It'll be third and 5. A manageable play, and there's Dustin Jones checking into the game, making a key first down catch. Nice job. So he does find a way to contribute here. Second and 8, Meadows looking for Ronnie Houston, and he's open. First down just outside of the red zone. Mark it at about the 22-yard line, and UMass is in business. Meadows to Houston on the long gain, and they fool the Hurricane defense right there. So let's get in. First and 10 run. It's Robert Vincent, and yes, he's got good blocking out front there. Takes it to the outside and gets a big first down run. He's back in a big way. Robert Vincent ready to contribute to this team. He brings that speed run element back here and makes them tricky to defend. First and goal. They bring a blitz, and they're going to get Meadows. It's a sack. He has no chance to even throw this ball away. Has to eat it for a loss. So nice blitz dialed up there by Miami, and they're going to force a second and goal from about the 15. Meadows is going to get a lot of that back to Ronnie Parker there on the curl route. Catches it at about the 5-yard line, and we'll get them a third and goal that is much more manageable. Now you can most likely choose to run or pass. They go run. Look at that block on the outside there by the tight end. Just destroys his man. And Robert Vincent can walk into the end zone. No one even close to getting out there on him. UMass takes the 7-3 lead with an 11-play, 83-yard drive capped off by the Robert Vincent run. Welcome back, freshman. Sullivan trying to lead Miami's offense down the field here to get them the lead. Bush makes this catch, and they convert the third down. Nice job. Second and two. Look out, Glover, going nowhere. Thomas Young buries him here. Nice play by the safety, running up here and making a big play. And as a matter of fact, he puts the running back down for the count. I don't know if he's out for the game, but he's out for right now. Third and seven, Sullivan. Another third down to try to convert. Oh, look at this. He hits Davis, and he gets enough, but he gets a big hit there. They convert another big third down. Second and 10, Sullivan to the sideline. Yep, give him that catch. First down. They now have a third and three. Yeah, they've converted a lot of third downs on this drive. Why not this one? Carter makes the catch, and it's another first down. Hand off to Davis up the middle, and he's not going down easily. He gets 10 yards right there. Third and five. They've converted all the third downs on this drive. Why not this one? Sullivan trying to get away. Oh, my goodness. He got absolutely beaten down there by a linebacker. They're going to have to settle for a field goal. And your halftime score is number one, UMass 7, and number 13, Miami 6. We got a close game here. UMass does hold the narrow lead on the road going into the second half, and they deferred, so they get the ball first. Robert Vincent, nice run to the left-hand side. He is very much that running back that we want to get. Runs off the edge, off tackle there, with blocking out front by tight ends and whoever might be leading the way. That is a recipe for success. They go play action, and he thinks he has Ronnie Parker open, but a lot of air under that ball ensures that the Miami defender can get under it and pick it off. Maybe a harder throw, and we get a connection there, but instead it's a turnover. So Sullivan gets the ball back and gets a chance to get more points for Miami. Not going to go down right away there. Only gets 2 yards. It's going to be third and long, third and eight. They did pretty good job converting on third downs in the first half. Here he's going to load up, and that's tipped around but cannot be completed there. It'll be fourth down and time to punt for the Hurricanes. First and 10 for Joel Meadows, and the Minutemen offense finds his tight end Stokes right there. And it'll be third and one. Robert Vincent follows his blocking for a first down. Nice job right there to move the chains. But look out, Meadows, from the blind side. He gets sacked and a 7-yard loss. They were sending people deep here, and it was a good time to bring a blitz. From the left-hand side, it gets him. So third and 17 now, Meadows. And another blitz, this time in his face, and it might have disrupted him here. Throwing to a covered receiver, and it is picked off once again. Miami coming up big on defense again, but they got to make UMass pay for the turnover and get some points. Sullivan wants to throw. No, there's a blitz in his face. It looks like safety Steve Coleman, who got him on that play. Sullivan throwing here deep, and no, sir. That's Steve Coleman, who just got the sack. He'll take an interception this time around, doing a little bit of everything. Oh, man, he's got Miami frustrated here. First, he blitz and brings down the quarterback on a sack. This time he's in coverage, and he robs one from the Hurricanes right there trying to throw the deep ball. He says, no way. So he gets the ball right back for UMass, and it's time to hand off to Robert Vincent. Going to fight right through there for 8 yards. He's got 59 so far and almost a 5 yard per carry average. Meadows on third and five. Probably should have thrown to the outlet at the sideline there. Instead, nobody's home over the middle of the field. Pretty much just getting rid of that one. They got a punt. Third and one now. Sullivan goes down. Miami's going backwards. It's Steve Coleman once again having a heck of a ball game when they dial up blitzes. And he gets another one right here in Sullivan's face, taking him down. Miami needs to punt. Second and 13, hitting Stokes over the middle is Joe Meadows. It'll be third and six after the result of that play. They need to convert right here into the sideline. It's Dobbs. Yes, sir, it's a catch. They want to go to the booth to make sure it was a good catch. Oh, it wasn't even close. Yeah, look, he's got that foot down with no problem. So that play will stand. They wanted to take a look and make sure they got it right, and they did the first time. So it's first down UMass, and they're going to call an audible here. A lot of shifting, and Miami's defense a little confused. Meadows is then going to flip the play to the left-hand side. It's going to be a counter from Vincent. Oh, they've got no counter for this. Look at, he's gone. Look at the speed. Oh, it's so great to have Robert Vincent back in that backfield, and he makes another huge play on the counter play. Wow, they really messed up Miami's D with all of the shifting on the line there, and then to deal with that speedy back just is not fair. Robert Vincent takes it to the house, and it is a 14-6 UMass lead. Sullivan trying to run again. Look out, he's drilled. Ball's on the ground. Miami cannot cover it, but Thomas Young can. The free safety falls on the ball, and it is a turnover. UMass gets the ball right back, and will have a short field. Boy, that's got to be deflating for Miami's offense right there as Sullivan took off, but he paid the price. Robert Vincent again. Can he juke him in? No, but he gets 8 yards. Second and two will turn into a third and two play. Follow the fullback, and he gets just enough. Robert Vincent, first down, and we have 5 minutes left to play. Hand off to Vincent again. He's going to get another 7 yards. Second and three. Joseph Jones in the ball game. He's going to get a big first down. The clock is still running. Miami's going to take timeout soon. Jones for another 4 yards there. Third and six. Can we convert this? Over the middle, the slant to Parker. Ronnie Parker gets a touchdown, and it's now 21-6 UMass. That could have been the dagger right there because Miami is now down a couple scores. And they're going to have to make it up in very little time remaining here. 3:22. They call for the slant on third and long. And Ronnie Parker comes through, getting himself open and catching the touchdown pass. Sullivan's going to hand off to Glover. Nope, no way. Steve Coleman, another big play. Third and nine. Is it Coleman again? Yes, it is. He's having an amazing game on this defense here. The freshman safety is just all over the field and all over Sullivan. They've got a punt. Third and eight. Meadows pump fakes and then goes to Ronnie Houston, and that will just about ice this game. The last timeout for Miami, and a nice conversion through the air. Robert Vincent's going to get another first down with under a minute to play. Nice run right there as they run the counter once again. Oh, look at that speed. Great to have him in our backfield once again. I mean, I don't know how to tell you what a dimension that adds to the lineup once again. So time runs out here, and UMass wins 21-6. They go to 12-0 and will be playing in the ACC championship game in a couple weeks here. Oh, wow. They've run the table so far. They're the number one team in the nation. Things are good for UMass these days. Miami, well, they're going to fall to 6-5. They should be in a bowl game. And, you know, they still have that ranking. We'll see how far they fall after today. So this should go even farther to get that recruiting and get these players in for years to come here. Robert Vincent, a product of that recruiting from Junk Johnson, doing a wonderful job. He's player of the game. Joel Meadows, another one of his recruits, 10 for 15, 124. A touchdown and two interceptions. That's not great. Two sacks as well. But he managed the game, and he handed off to this guy, Robert Vincent, enough to get the win. 24 attempts for 152 yards. Welcome back, Robert Vincent. He's still technically considered injured there. He was probable. Obviously, he played, and he played well. You see the receiving stats, and then we'll go to the defensive stats as well. Steve Coleman, your defensive MVP for the day, just everywhere here on the field. 81 overall freshman, doing work. So there you go, 21-6 victory. It's time to hit the recruiting trail once again. It'll be nice to do that with a 12-0 record and a number one ranking to tout to these guys. Sean Luke, we added him to the board not that long ago, and we scout him up, and he's looking really good, 78 overall. JJ Gilliam, the athlete here, 74 overall. Let's bump that up a little, maybe. Yeah, 76. Okay, looking good. No bust here. Larry Thompson, we know he's an 81 overall, 100% scouted. We want to get him in here, working on him. Michael Henry, considered a bust, but still a 76 overall. Would be definitely great depth for this offensive line. Sean Luke, the free safety, who we just scouted out to 70%, working on him. JJ Gilliam, we scouted him a little bit as well. Still trying to get him in. He's got Miami number one. Maybe he'll change his mind after what he saw this week. Kyle Bailey, an athlete. Middle linebacker Joel Lamb, still working on these guys. Some of these guys are secondary. So we're going to advance into what will be a bye week for us. And then we are going to see who we play in the ACC championship game, as we know we'll be there. We're 12-0 and going undefeated. We know we'll be in that ACC championship game. Number one with all the first place votes there. Oregon number two. Michigan State to number three. Michigan was number two coming in, but they lost to Ohio State, so they dropped down. And your Heisman watch, these are all fictitious guys now in year five, but I'll show it to you anyway. It's all halfbacks and one quarterback there. It looks like in the Heisman watch, no UMass players, maybe next year. We're not really on that level statistic-wise, even though we're having some team glory this year. So that's where everything looks. Oh, Sean Luke soft for Purdue. Oh, I hope we can change his mind. I really want that young free safety right there. But we'll already have a good class committed. We're just trying to round it off, maybe being a little bit greedy there, but we'll take whoever we can. We get Joel Lamb, and we get Franklin, the wide receiver, who I think was like a 67 or 68 overall. You know, he may be a project. So Georgia Tech it'll be. Number 14, Georgia Tech at 9-3 versus the number one in the nation, UMass Minutemen, for the ACC Championship when we come back next. Don't miss that one, guys. It's going to be a classic. We'll see you then.